Network. TFNN. Headline news update.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN, 9 a.m. Eastern time, Friday morning. Happy Friday to everybody out there. 30 minutes to go until the opening bell. And right now, we got markets in positive territory. Looking at an S&P positive by almost 2%, 59 points in the green, trading at 3,059. NASDAQ up 147, trading 97.51. The Dow up 561, trading 25,590. We'll start things off. Let's jump over to the VIX contract. My computer's a little slow right now. I think that's going on. Continue. Performance problem detected is telling me. Tell this computer to keep up. There we go. Checking out your VIX. Talk about an elevated price yesterday to 42.58 from 26 and change, folks. We're back to 37. The remarkable thing about the VIX is that it was indicating elevated premium, elevated risk probability in this market because you reached a low on Friday morning. Yet the market was still hanging at highs, but somehow the VIX was, as they would say, creeping all week, even above 27 on Tuesday. The S&Ps were still at 3,200. And of course, you see the collapse on Thursday. People say out of nowhere, you're going to see this type of volatility. Nonetheless, VIX at 37.35. You check out the overnight action for the S&Ps. We make a low at about 6 p.m. last night in the S&Ps. That level below 3,000, if my chart will cooperate, isn't going to load. There it is, 29.92. After the market closes, we're up to about 3,057. A solid rebound. But this type of volatility, always fun to see what happens on the opening bell. And if the market was right overnight, or if when the buyers and sellers actually meet at the opening bell, maybe things cascade back to even territory for the day. Hertz. So why not? You tell the world you're going to go bankrupt, you go into bankruptcy proceedings, and then your stock goes up by tenfold. And you say, hey, why do we need to go bankrupt when we can just issue more shares if everybody wants to buy Hertz shares? They're going to try and raise $1 billion. Folks, I would not be buying this. Hertz said it would warn any potential buyers the common stock could ultimately be worthless, period, end of sentence. Buyer beware. Numbers on the radar, UK. That economy contracted by more than 20% in April, those numbers out. The global economy, the IMF, saying it's going to suffer significant scarring. They are out with their projections June 24th, and they're going to be worse than they were in April. And what else did I have up there? Yeah, the mortgage bailout. So numbers going down still. 4.66 million people, almost 1 out of 11 mortgage holders in forbearance right now. And those numbers are going to come to roost. Stay tuned, folks. Larry Pesavento coming up live with Trade What You See. I'll be back at 10 o'clock with Tom. Live programming all day. We'll be right back. Stay tuned for Larry.